do something very interesting. Why does the shopkeeper always have to be dead? Okay, here he is. Alright, so, we want to have a setup that's kind of like this. A legendary cosmic blade with as many gladiators on it as you can put on it. A whole bunch of hands, including this dream hand here. This will be our failsafe. And a Mr. Genzi's exit. We want to have the item rank at, enemy rank at minimum. And go into the item world of the Cosmic Blade. We are going to be perfecting our Cosmic Blade, perhaps getting the Yoshitsuna, and just being awesome in general. Our first step is to clear out of any innocents that are, inside this item world before we reach floor 10. This is entirely luck dependent, but hopefully I'll run into all three of them. Okay, there's innocent number one. Why does it have to be all the way over there? Video games. Buddha Man. Shazam. Okay, innocent number two. Making good progress. Can't use Lion's Roar, because reasons. But you know what? Whatever. Highest level in the game, Joshua, is 9,999. And even then, that's not the highest stats you can get. You can build up 186,000 stored levels before your stat bonuses max out. I thought that was the, whatever. Gate is up there. For reasons. By the way, while you are going down, you will want to check for any legendary rank 39 items on your way on the characters on your way through the item world. Yeah, pretty much. Just stacking stat bonuses onto stat bonuses and constantly reincarnating. The ideal level to reincarnate would be around level 1500 to 2000. Just because it's so fast to get there. Of course, in Etna mode, that might be different because the enemies already start out so high. Alright, and there's, innocent number 3. Alright, now I can use a Mr. Gensi exit to get out. And then we finish loading up the Cosmic Blade with, Innocence. Since swords are a primarily attack-based weapon, we want to use gladiators. And we can only put 10 innocents on this particular cosmic blade, although you can get slots with up to, blades with up to 13 innocent slots. In any case, let's put our infernal fist back on. Heal up. Grab another exit out of the warehouse just to be safe. And return to the item world. Once the enemies get to be around half your character's level, you probably want to start killing them again. Just to pick up that extra experience on the way. Cave of Ordeals 3 won't get you to 9999, I can guarantee you that. Unless you are ridiculously patient. Already played Majora's Mask. It's pretty cool. Alright, here's the item general. This is the only unit we have to kill before floor 10, besides the Innocents. Once we've killed him, we can go straight into the Dimensional Gate. Although, if you're low on Mr. Gensi exits, you might want to kill everything. There's a legendary Infernal Fist over there, which might come in handy, actually. Assuming I can't find a legendary God's Hand deeper in. Who had that again? You, Jack. Okay. Your fist is now mine! Ah ha 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 ha!
Buddha Man! Booyah!
And we can return to the Overlord's castle now. As you can see, our Cosmic Blade gained a huge bonus in attack, about 500, because it registered that we killed the item general. Next step, proceed to level 20, kill the item general again. Also, put this in the warehouse. Cue the music.
Shazam! Shazam! Shazam!
This is looking pretty dangerous, but we have a lot of units with high move, so shouldn't be too much of a problem.
Shazam! Shazam!
We're getting pretty lucky here with our, warp placements. They're all pretty close to the base. Here's floor 20. Kill item general number 2.
Booyah!
And at this point, you are free to return to the castle. Although... oh, that's not a cosmic blade. That's a spear. It's not even a sword. As you can see, I gained about 600 attack again because we killed the item general with this many innocents on the sword. At this point, our level 30 Legendary Cosmic Blade is slightly stronger than the Infernal Fist currently equipped on my Uber Rogue. This is good, it means we're on the right track. Ooh, experience plus 50%. Probably want to kill a few enemies here. And you had to spawn all the way over there, of course. Hello? What kind of sword is that? That is a this is what a cosmic blade looks like, by the way. It's not a legendary cosmic blade though, so we can leave it be. Only legendary cosmic blades will give you a Yoshitsuna in their item world. Oxygen thug. I think I want to get rid of this geo symbol. That might have been a bad decision. Oh well, Dr. Vaughn can heal himself, so it's not a huge issue.
Shazam!
What is this song? It's so wonky. This looks like trouble. Okay. Is the music any different for Item Kings? It is. This is the normal boss theme, but still, it's different from usual. Alright, so item kings are even more important to kill than item generals, because when you kill the item king, the innocent capacity of an item goes up by one. They appear every 30 floors. Also, it would be helpful for me if you would get off the invincible panel, Mr. Item King. At this point, we can put one more innocent on our cosmic blade. Luckily for us, we happen to have one more gladiator on our infernal fist here. So now we're good until floor 60. Let's go. Starting to get to the point where Dr. Vaughn might only be useful for healing. Gonna try and keep him leveled, though. there, really? Has to be those things, too. Ugh. This does not bode well for the fabric of the universe. Let's see if we can kill one of them. That worked out in the end. Let's see. You, Mr. Deschernabog, have an accelerator, so I'm gonna wanna take that. We could get another accelerator if we raise the bonus gauge to 1, but I'm not really seeing. Well, I guess we could geo combo, but kind of in a rush here to get to the bottom. You have an accelerator, but. Definitely want to get rid of that. Man. This is a galactic staff. It's the rank 39 staff. Nobody else has anything I'm interested in, though. Artemis is the rank 39 bow, but we're not really using bows. And if we were, it's just a normal Artemis. It's not even legendary.
Spider-Man!
Sauces, isn't it? Mr. the Doctor. Yeah, you're not leveling up a whole lot at all. Probably should have just taken you to the Cave of Ordeals. Shazman's strong enough to do most of this on his own, I think. Okay, level 40, and the item general is all the way over here. Great. Alright, well, let's clear out the dudes over here.
Shazam!
So if they have a throwing character come out, they won't be thoroughly obliterated.
Tragic tale of the cyclopic race and the horrid tale of horrid siblings. And me. Due to their innate abilities to survive most mortal blows after consuming red radishes, the armless bipedal cyclops demons were seen as the perfect minion for the great space masters of space. Many of the cyclopses were put to work in the great leak mines of Utopia.
Shazam!
Coming into the treacherous muncher pits of Munchtopia, they were only fed when they weren't big, and even then, only when they were needed. Many starved to death several times in a row before being fed. Brainwashing was the best way to keep the Cyclopses in line. Doing food they love? Food. This is going way beyond their head. They eventually staged a grand rebellion called the Grand Rebellion. After they discovered the ability to shoot balls
in
their eyes, they were forced to be reckoned with. They were known across the universe as the Great Cyclops Grand Rebellion. Unfortunately, the revolution was staged during the Great Green Radish Famine of October. Cyclopses starved to death again. Eventually, the armless bipedal cyclopic demons were... Wait, armless bipedal cyclopic demons? That's ABCD! Anyway, the armless cyclopic demons are extinct. Starved to complete the death. Very sad. Never again will they graze in the Cyclop Hills or enjoy the yearly sacrifice. Nor will they crave their delicious cyclopic life. Months passed. A crazed psycho known only as the artist learned of the cyclopic race from a book he found in the old library found in the ancient monastery up far away into the north, and sought to clone the fabled cyclopic race as brainwashed minions to assist him in conquering the galaxy. Science was the artist's first attempt at creating a cyclopic life form. Due to a lack of resilience in his body, he deteriorated down to a curious floating eyeball shortly following his creation. As technology progressed, he was equipped with an unidentified flying object that allowed him to ask questions to satisfy his curiosity. Since then, he's built up a sizable amount of knowledge, but his hardware isn't developed enough for him to speak more than a few broken words at once. He tends to slowly take charge over the other siblings, and is currently in search of the Super Leaks across the multiverse. Recently, he upgraded himself and looks terribly out of place, unbugged by it. Pandemona was the second Cyclops created. Attempting to rectify the mistakes made while creating the science, the artist added nails during the creation process to increase resilience. Due to this, she came out extremely unstable and had to be put in a box to limit her power. She's the worst combination imaginable, powerful, and incredibly paranoid. Dense as a brick, she will shoot at anything and everything moving in her direction. You seem to have had no trouble with her so far. I would suggest avoiding her in the future, though. She's very power-crazed, and outfit your blood in particular. The artist's next attempt at creating the perfect minion was Garrosh, the Lord of the Group. Believing he was on the correct path previously, the artist added less nails to Garrosh, but clearly didn't have enough, as Garrosh came out all slimy and melting, suffering from an odd his Napoleon complex, Garrosh believes himself to be the greatest of all the siblings. He is fiercely militaristic, and declares himself the honorary leader of the Cyclops race. None of us take this seriously, though. Not because he's an incompetent leader, more because he's a kind of just a objectivist jerk. He recently adopted the name Johnson McKean for himself, weirdo. Yaris fails the enemy because of stupidity prevalent in the previous two siblings. So he decided to spice it up and use a peaceful fire for his next one. Due to this, Nevada came out a little weird and poisonous. Lacking legs, he's forced to stand on his feet all the time. Although very content with nature and plants and stuff, he's very shy and jittery. He is downright obsessed with plants and enjoys tending to impressive gardens. He's fiercely antagonistic towards vegetarians and carnivores, and he's a good people, especially those he's unfamiliar with. If you encounter him, pretend to like plants a lot. Maybe chivalrous enough to scare you. For you, the artist decides to have a
food.
She's a real guy.
Uh-oh. Okay. Disaster averted. Maybe.
I always wear a tinfoil hat around her to block her mind control powers. The psychic powers allow her to do many creepy and weird things. She's very lazy and emotionless, though, and tends to mostly use them to teach ants to feel pain. I believe she's in league with the government. I would totally want to
do that.
She loves to play mind games. And walls and bridges.
My
Animal Fantasy, she's a John Lennon fan. I was created next. Garrosh speaks of fire as the catalyst in my creation. I'm perfect in
every
Calioka is weird. The catalyst for her was in Japan. Japan as the universal constant is now canon. Calioka is a shapeshifter. However, she doesn't have full control over this ability of hers, so she can easily become quite hectic and stressed once something goes wrong. In her true form, she looks like any of the other siblings. One eye, no arms and such, but whatever, she shapes into her own has one eye. She's a huge fan of Australian culture, and uses our greatest historians. She tends to teleport herself between different worlds and dimensions, and often takes on a role fitting to the situation, with devoted devotion due to her schizophrenia. And then the artist made you two, Demo and Iris. The catalysts of you were the exact opposite of the previous catalysts. A bunch of packing peanuts, a slab of meat, a lead weight, asbestos, and most importantly, a kangaroo. Somewhere along the line, you two escaped his brainwashing powers and found a new home with the mother
master.
It's all up to you, Demo, to free your other siblings from the evil brainwashing as you freed me. Go forth, yon Demo, and smite thine enemies. Be on the lookout for that tricky government that will try to impede your progress. Good luck.
That is not very beneficial to me. Angel's Sandals, by the way, increase your move by 2. They're a few ranks below the Accelerator. If you find one of those and aren't already stocked up on Accelerators, I would recommend just taking it. It's a thing. Also, wow, you are kind of... existing that... Oh, for a second I was going to say, that killed Dr. Vaughn? That's crazy town. But it in fact did not. There, Mr. Demogin. How do you do? Don't giga fire me. I'm just trying to say hi. For that, I will kill you! Oh, ha 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 ha! Final boss theme from a Rurouni no Hiho. Exodus, that is the, that emblem is, a couple ranks higher than the Testament, but it's below the Arcadia. I say to you, sure, why not, let's grab it. That should do a trick. Whoa, baby. Let's get you out of here. I've never beaten it. I got to the end of Serlent's story, but the boss was too hard. Yeah, I just need to level grind a bit more, I don't know. When a monster type unit goes over level 100, it starts getting a mastery for monster weapons. Yeah. It's an invisible stat, but it's a direct function of their level, so high level monsters are definitely something you want to avoid. Also, Trauma Center music. How fitting. Got Dr. Vaughn out here, although this is actually from Trauma Center Under the Knife 2. Anyway, Exodus, get. Chen? This isn't Toho.
Shazam! Shazam!
As you can see, already our Cosmic Blade is level 50 and has over 16,000 attack. If we equip this on a character with high mastery, for example, Alice here, this would be the result. She'd be right up there with our other Uber units. We're getting into kind of dangerous territory here. I will say that. Let's see, you have a normal Cosmic Blade, but didn't I already, actually, when I think about it? Seems like something I might have had already. No, Joshua, the stream is not over. Apparently, one of my viewers is having connection problems. Also, this could get ugly if I don't run it and Big Bang them.
Shazam!
Infernal Gun is the rank 39 gun, but I already have one of those. Go on, Stripes! What, you're just gonna walk around in front of me?
You're not even gonna come up? Come on, kitty! Kitty, 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 kitty!
Cats. I'm telling you. Meow!
Meow! What's that supposed to mean?
She's meowing at me for reasons. Isn't owning cats wonderful? Yep, this is the item world. Ack, I definitely want to get rid of this somehow. Lovely. Alright, let's just try to power through. Oh, silence. That is a big problem. This is why save states are a thing. Cornette, this isn't Rhapsody, a Musical Adventure. What are you doing here? Crazy town. Let's see, the Item King has an accelerator on him. Ooh, Rare God's Hand, I want that. It's on the high night, okay. Have such a weird voice in this game. Surfer. Alright, Mr. The Item King is no threat to me at all, so... You are the Item King, right? Yeah. Let's just take that fist. Take that fist! You have a lot of HP.
Hootaman!
I'll be taking that, thank you. Alright, item king number 2, dead. Character needs it later. Save. We might not be able to finish this item world with our current levels, but we've got the Cave of Ordeals 3 right there, so if it turns out that we are powerless to continue, then I'll just start grinding. Nirvana is the rank 39 armor, but we don't care about armor. Well, this is a thing. It's just asking for an area of effect Terra Star. I even killed some dudes. That's great. I love killing dudes. Lon Lon Ranch. Rare angel sandals, those are nice, I guess. Thank you. This is why we make our healers powerful. Dang it! Stop going after him! I would never do to you guys.
Shazam!
It's an Omega Majin, that's why thing is happening the way it's happening. Die! Yeah, these aren't giving you very much experience at all. Oh no, Zelda music. Oh wait, I forgot to put another thing on the... Well... Okay, but it's one round of stuff missed, so... While we might not have our perfect cosmic blade, that is just fine, because it will be pretty dang powerful when we're done with it. Meaning I probably want to kill you.
Shazam!
Just to keep you away from Dr. That happened. Okay, here's the level 70 item, General. You have a lot of HP. Of course, why that surprised me at this point, I do not know. Legendary Infernal Bow is nice, but again, we are not really using bows right now. Prism Mage has a God's Hand, but it's not legendary, so we're probably going to ignore it. Let's see if I can't find another gladiator put on our thing. Let's see. Aha! This Karate Chop has a gladiator on it. Over there.
Shazam! Shazam!
Hey. Aha! You are a marksman. That is not what we are looking for. But the other guys got rid of you first, so yeah. The same marksman, aren't you? You're just that. No, you are the gladiator we're looking for. Okay. Let's take you down.
Shazam!
Oh no, Keith Courage. Buying residence is the last thing we want to be doing. It's dangerous territory. Level 1466, which is crazy beans. You have a rare infernal gun, but I'm not really interested in gun units right now. I mean, I needed a scout to unlock the I need a scout to unlock the Majin, but I don't really plan on using him at all. More HP than I can reasonably deal with. A lot of people with fists, but no legendary god's hands. Stranger, this isn't Zedai Hero Project. What are you doing here? You have two legendary items. Lucky you. rare Cosmic Blade, but we are already in the Actually, you know what? Yes, I will get that. Okay, level 80 item, general. You have an accelerator. And you have a lot of HP. Take us home! ...27,000 attack. Let's go. ...1,657 and higher. It's crazy beans. I misread the names of the top two enemies as Hector and Vector, and I was gonna be like, this isn't Gyromite, but one, nobody would get that, and two, it was not in fact Vector. You are kind of in the way there, Mr. Shark. Ack, what? Crazy town. Oh, never mind. I don't know what I'm freaking out about. While we're here, might as well big bang everything into oblivion. Get some more levels. Why the heck not?
Shazam! Shazam!
That's probably enough. It's a cosmic blade! Not much use to me, though. At least not right now.
Shazam!
I would have named him Shazam, but I misspelled it, so we ended up with Shazman, which is actually funnier, if you think about it.
Man.
Who the man? You have a lot of level. This is starting to make me nervous. You have a heartless sword. It's the Arundite. Nothing doing. Of course, there's a dude on top of the thing. This is why we have fist units, ladies and gentlemen. Remember way back when I was carting that weak sauce for the item world as Laharl? This is why. You have two accelerators, that's crazy town. Alright, level 90 item king. Whoops. I was one floor off. In this situation, there is only one thing you can say to that. Oh, I missed! Also, great Gianna sisters. It sure is a thing. Watch, this next item king is gonna have like a million HP.
Shazam!
Here's the item king! Infernal. Okay, 360k isn't bad. Neither is having a rare infernal gun, but again, I am not really too concerned with collecting guns. I do not need to brast anything with my guns.
Shazam!
And you're shooting me doesn't even accomplish anything because my defense is so ridiculously high.
Shazam! Shazam!
Okay, Item King is dead. This means we can hunt down one more, innocent. This Jupiter's Fist has a gladiator. Let's go there. That is not very convenient for us. I spy an innocent. And it looks like he is within range of our magic. Alright, innocent get. Truth, guys. At this point, we are incapable of killing any of our enemies in one hit. The Cosmic Blade. Oh, these are worth a whole lot. Okay, I guess I killed that one in one hit. Flandre, what are you doing here? Actually, that's probably not how you really pronounce it. It's more like Flandre. But details. Okay, floor 98. If you want to get a specific rarity rank 40 weapon, then you probably want to use your Mr. Genzi exit here and save the game. Not us, though. We just want to keep going. Are you ready, guys? Came all this way? Time to kick some butt. That's him, the item god. And that is his weapon. Also, he has 2 million HP for some reason. Just need to be able to get to him. Here he comes. Moment of truth. Can I steal the Yoshitsuna? What else do you have? A gold tuxedo? That's useless. Got it! The text box is broken. Alright, that reduces your HP a little bit. Now, killing the item god will result in a different ending should you continue onward to Seraph Lamington. But since we're playing Etna mode, that won't matter. Even so, I'm gonna try to take you down. Along with all the other dudes here. You are kind of hurting me for a lot of damage here. Whoa! You have a unique portrait. That's crazy town. Let's see if I can't Omega heal you. And how much move do you have? You have a lot of move. Not as much as me, though. I wonder, what else is here? Enemy boost, color change, lifting. Yeah, we probably want to keep all of that put. I'm pretty confident in my ability to beat him. He's not doing a whole lot of damage to Shazman here, but it might take a while. Down from there. Thank you. You actually listened to me. You know, it would really suck if the counter glitch happened because the item god has too many counters and the game froze. That would really suck. Of course, I made a save state, but still. For those of you playing this on the PSP, I am sorry if that happens. No, Dr. Vaughn is gonna die now before the counter glitch even has a chance to happen. So we're good, as long as we don't actually die. About 6 more hits should do it.
Hootaman. Hootaman.
Where do you think you're going?
Hootaman.
Almost got him. 2 more hits, guys. It's Mr. Random iPod. You came in at the moment of truth. I'm about to kill the item god.
Shazam!
One more hit and I would have been done for. But... I got him! Yoshitsuna get, and Mr. Gensi exit get. 40,000 attack power, ladies and gentlemen. What? Who the heck is Lilith? So, an interesting thing about Yoshitsuna. Let's equip it on Alice, first of all. Her move goes up by 2 just from having it equipped, but that's not all. That is not all. The Yoshitsuna has an attack range of 5. Look at that! It's a thing! It's a thing! It's the best weapon in the game! Besides maybe the Nemesis fully powered up, but still. And look at that! This weapon is so awesome, its icon goes outside of the stat box. It's a thing! The really silly playthrough, you might be referring to either Laharl or Etna. Now that the main story is over, I'm not doing a Laharl solo run anymore. That would be just ridiculous. And put this Cosmic Blade away. And we can equip this Cosmic Blade to Alice. Look at that attack power! That is just the most ridiculous thing I have ever seen. And once we get her leveled up... Explosion. This is a... Mr. Random iPod, this is a let's not screw up the post-game run. We can put all these away now. They're of little use to us at present. That'll work. The damage cap is several billion, I believe, Annie. Anyway, we only have 20 more minutes until this episode of the stream is officially over. But I'm just gonna keep going. I'm in too good of a mood to stop. Let's give Alice the level grinding treatment, shall we? Winged Slayer is great against these guys. Look at that, she gained over 100 levels. Postgame is ours. And we haven't even leveled up the Yoshitsuna yet. Once we get that thing in our hands, we will be unstoppable. By the way, Annie, since you're a Dynasty Warriors fan, I wanted to ask you, have you heard anything about this Dragon Quest Warriors game? It sounds awesome. I just heard about it today. Let's see if it's actually a thing or not. It's not the attack that's overpowered, Mr. Random iPod, it's the sword. And again, just wait until we level up the Yoshitsuna. You go ahead and do that and tell me what you find, Annie. I'm curious. Also, you know what would be really awesome? Disgaea Warriors. That would be the awesomest thing ever. Let's raise the enemy rank a little bit. Also, let's split up the stream. I am going to pause the stream right now. I'll be back in a few minutes, and then we can just keep going all night without having to worry about content ID at all.